Good evening and welcome to Candles and Carols. It is so good to be back with you for a live performance. It's been 2 years, right? So this is the 57th annual Candles and Carols here at Anderson University. And it is a great tradition that we are so pleased to carry on tonight. We've talked with our students quite a bit this week about the significance of a tradition and how important it is to handle it with care and to be sure that it's passed on to those who come after us. And we're so happy to be part of a tradition that's this meaningful, this deeply rooted in our community. So thank you for joining us here tonight. I also want to welcome our special guests for tonight. We're happy to have members of the Anderson Area Concert Choir and Youth Chorale and their conductors, Amy Hughley and Lauren Souther. Would you please welcome our guest singers? If there's anyone here tonight who would be interested in auditioning for the School of Music, Theater, and Dance, we would be happy to talk with you afterwards. Any of the conductors or I would be happy to talk with you. You can also go to our website and get audition information there. And if you fill out a form there, we'll be right back in touch with you. That comes directly to our office, and we respond very quickly to those. So we hope that you will consider being a part of our community here at Anderson University. And now I get to come to that moment that everybody looks forward to where I ask you to take out the phone and silence it. But before you silence it, go to Facebook and follow Anderson University School of Music, Theater, and Dance so that we can send you updates and reminders about what's going on here. We have lots and lots of performances every semester, and we would love for you to be here for those performances. But then you have to turn off yourself. And I want to remind you that the highlight of this program every year is hearing you sing. So when we come to those carols where the audience sings along, please engage with that. As John Wesley would say, sing lustily and with good courage, and not as if you were half asleep. Those are his words, not mine. So please be a part of that and have fun with it. There is also, I want to remind you, there is a television monitor in the lobby. Should you have a coughing spell or a restless child during the performance, feel free to step into the lobby and then come back and join us for the rest of the performance after that. Well, we've been through a difficult time over the last several months, but we hope tonight that the music and the dance that we share with you will bring hope and healing to each of you. And I invite you to take the program that you were given tonight and take it with you when you go home. Because the words of these pieces that we sing tonight have been with us for generations, in some cases for centuries. They are great words to ponder during this Advent and Christmas season. So we hope you will think of that as a guide through the season. And we hope that this evening of beauty will awaken something in you of hope that is so integral to this Advent season. Thank you for joining us.
In those days, Caesar Augustus published a decree ordering a census of the whole Roman world. This first census took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All the people were instructed to go back to the towns of their births to register. And so, Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to the city of David, Bethlehem, in Judea. Because Joseph was of the house and lineage of David, he went to register with Mary, his espoused wife, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her delivery. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She put him in a simple cloth wrapped like a receiving blanket and laid him in a feeding trough for cattle, because there was no room for them at the inn.
Oh, Thank you.
Let this be a sign to you. You'll find an infant wrapped in a simple cloth, lying in a manger. Suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in high heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom God's favor rests." When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go straight to Bethlehem and see this event that God has made known to us." They hurried and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger.
Thank you.
In the beginning, there was the Word. The Word was in God's presence, and the Word was God. The Word was present to God from the beginning. Through the Word, all things came into being. And apart from the Word, nothing came into being that has come into being. In the Word was life, and that life was humanity's light. A light that shines in the darkness. A light that darkness has never overtaken. He was in the world, and though the world was made through the Word, the world didn't recognize it. Though the Word came to its own realm, the world's own people didn't accept it. Yet, anyone who did accept the Word, who believed in that name, were empowered to become children of God. Children born not of descent, nor urge of flesh, nor human will, but born of God. And the Word became flesh, and stayed for a little while among us, and saw the Lord's glory, the favor and position a parent gives an only child, filled with grace, filled with truth.
Thank you. it is so good to be with you here in person. Such a blessing to come together where we can celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm just wondering, for some of you, I know you are first-time guests here. Can I just see a show of hands if you're a first-time guest? Wonderful, wonderful. Welcome. It is so good to see you.
Dispel some of that darkness. But when there are hundreds of lights, hundreds of candles, perhaps a thousand here tonight, how that can dispel the darkness. Many lights join together. So I encourage you, this day, this evening, this coming day, this weekend, each and every day, to find that one light that you can rely on, that Scripture describes, and let your light shine so you can be a blessing to others, so their light can shine and they also can be a blessing. So I'd like to invite the usher now to come forward, and as the lights start going down, and as we sing this wonderful hymn, Silent Night, we will share the passing of the light with these hundreds of lights. Amen.
Thank you.
God's gifts of light and peace be with you and your loved ones now and throughout this holy season. Amen.